Yo, I am Dustin Mikesell, and this is the Watchmen, Inc. podcast. Are you tired of the deception of the Matrix? Here, we will build a case around God's plan for the mad world, using biblical history and the application of the scriptures to provide hope and truth in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Mike 777.
Why is let me get my. I had to get your voice to come through my headphones, and so yeah, that sound good now.
Yeah,
Mike. I mean, I got it for like $100. My brother-in-law got me an Amazon card, and I was like, it's probably better than these crappy headphone speakers or the mic, the webcam.
The webcam. The issue happens is the webcam will pick up your monitor, and they'll make like a loop. And it'll like destroy the audio.
I'm still like, let me open.
Still get it through, huh?
Yeah, still just trying to get set up, and I'm like trying to redo my computer room right now because, you know, like I said, I just had a new baby. So yeah, time's flying right now, and it's hard to get anything that I like want to get done every day because I have so much. But I'm like, you know, posting the Instagram story. That's kind of like where my base is at right now. So this is kind of the lane I'm sticking to just keep content rolling, because, you know, once you get into this space, you got to like do it daily or else you kind of just get lost in the mix, you know?
Yeah. So no, it's good that you keep it rolling, man. I mean, for me, like as a programmer, I hit these like huge bumps that go on like weeks at a time where I just don't want to look at the code because I just know that the next amount of tasks that I need to do is going to take like, you know what I mean? It's just going to be such a big one.
Yeah.
I just like avoid it, you know?
So it's good to finally get on, you know, space and do some recording, because I do want to like share this with my people, because I've been telling them that this is kind of stuff I want to get into, because, you know, Instagram's great for the flash and getting people, you know, woken up to what's going on or presenting, you know, articles or just current events. You know, I think that's why most people are on these social spaces, just kind of keep up with daily events that are happening, because stuff moves so fast now that can't even blink. Like I said, I got started with all this in December with Balenciaga, you know, with all that crap happening. I feel like that was an eternity ago already, you know.
That was when?
That was December-ish of last year, which is crazy. It's already been that much time, but that's like when that whole thing kind of dropped, and when, you know, the Lord was like, time to get public, because, you know, Balenciaga kind of ties into a lot of stuff that I've been presenting, and just, you know, fashion is a huge thing, not only in America, but the world. So, yeah, that's kind of like, you know, we don't want to say bad words here because that'll get you canceled, but it really ties into some stuff that, you know, people say, oh, that's conspiracy and all that. But it's like, but you start looking at all these like artists,
how, and
all
these, like, yeah, like look at the art they're producing.
Yes.
And
yes.
tell me they're not all, like, they're already singing about it.
Exactly, that's what
you
I mean,
know,
like,
like they're not even hiding it.
Cocaine and drinking with your friends, you live in the dark, boy, I cannot pretend. I'm not faced, only you to sin. If you live in your garden, you know that you can. Call me when you want, call me when you need, call me in the morning, I'll be on the way.
Actually, you know, the one that is a big, big known one that's a popular one is Jerry Lee Lewis. He's the one that's saying Great Balls of Fire.
Okay.
I don't know if you know him, but he's actually his guess who the drummer of his band was Drake's dad. I'm pretty sure. I'd have to like, I'm pretty sure that's a known fact that Drake's dad was the drummer of Jerry Lee Lewis. And Jerry Lee Lewis, like, literally loved his younger cousin or something like that, like some really, yeah, and he loved young girls, and yeah, he was a sicko. So there's that tie already.
Wild,
like,
man, like the fucking, like, you know, it's like, I always had my doubts about Drake, like the Disney guy, right? Drake and Josh.
The rapper. Yeah, okay. Drake the rapper.
Yeah, yeah. Because, like, he was a Disney child, which means you don't just get in on that, you know? And then his...
Was he Disney or what? I know he was Degrassi. He was a Degrassi kid. Yeah, I remember that show Degrassi with all these, like... I loved it as a kid because it was, like, child drama. But I won't lie. I watched some of it because they have it on the TV, you know, like those pre-made channels that just, like, play, like, random TV shows if you don't have cable. They've got, like, a Degrassi channel. There's some pretty, like, you know, that's the thing, like... probably that will guide us right into what we want to talk today about. Like, there's just some very subjective things that, like, these artists and these, like, entertainers and these quote idols that, you know, we look up to and we expect to, like, lead the way in all these different, like, categories in our life, from, like, what we should believe, how we should treat people, to, like, things we should be doing to the community or supporting, you know? And, like, it's just gotten so out of hand that, like, we literally look at these people like gods. Like,
clips from Degrassi, The Next Generation, Time Still Stands, Part 2.
Is that real?
The whole time you pretended to be my friend. You made me do this.
They look at us as, like, they look at us like cattle, because we're just, like, under a tier of, like, society. Like, you'll never understand what it's like to be rich and famous until you're there, because they just, you know, they live.
I've often was in positions where I can use whatever power I have over somebody, and, like, I just never, you know, like, you know, it happens all the time, you know, but it's like,
right,
you don't take advantage of it. You're honest and you treat everybody humanely. But to be a celebrity and then to, like, really abuse the fact that you have that net of, like, celebrity, that you could do anything or, like, gain the trust of anybody, and, like, dude, it's psychopathic. No, you know what? It's not psychopathic. I think it's more predatory behavior. It's like beta male behavior.
It just goes back to history, bro. It's like Babylonian history. Like, if you go and study ancient Babylon, like I said, that's actually the first time when, you know, like, and everybody that follows my channel, at least, they know that I'm Christian. I follow, you know, Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. So that's part of, like, the whole reason to expose all this, is because it ties so much into the biblical stuff that people, like, they sit there and they say, oh, the Bible's meant to control you. But it's exposing everything. It's like God trying to tell humans, like, look, yeah, I've given you the ability to choose with free will, like, you know, and I want you to choose me, but there's also another choice, which is no or the dark, you know what I mean?
Dude, the
inversion is crazy, and that's why, you know, like, Aleister Crowley, do what thou will, or, like, you know, the esoteric, above, as above, so below, like, this is what these people believe in, like, regardless of what your beliefs are as a human, like, these celebrities and these people that are in this space or get into these things, like these occultic pagan, like, practices, they believe in it. Like, they truly, like, they're all about, like, manifesting.
They think it's their God.
It's Satan. Like, they worship Satan, and they're not afraid to say it.
It's like they genuinely internalize that is their God, and their God needs these rituals, and they view it as worship.
Yes.
You know, and you know, some of the inversions, man, that society is going through is, like, leverage yourself into debt, and that's called earning money. Or, you know, it's like marriage is a prison. It's like, no, marriage actually frees you, you know?
Yes.
Now you're not of – now it's like, you know, women go out all the time, and it's like they're always on the lookout for, like, guys that are trying to, you know, like, you know, basically every dude's just trying to fuck them when they go out, right? So it's like, but marriage will keep you from that, you know? It's like, that will prevent you from being preyed upon, you know?
Yeah, and going, it,
Yeah.
No, exactly, bro. And marriage isn't even the same, you know, of what it is. They used to have incentives. Like, if the government really wanted society to keep going forward and progressing in a, like, they would incentivize being married, but they don't. They don't incentivize being married. They give you a few bucks for having a kid, you know, because they're like, well, obviously a kid is expensive as hell to have, especially in today's society. So they don't even promote that. I mean, I got the hospital bill for my new baby. It's expensive, just to stay in the room and board. Yeah. Okay. Just to give you rough estimates. Legit. Cause everybody's different. Everyone's different. Obviously, you know, my wife's she's in healthcare, so we get really good insurance, and we're blessed, but 20,000 just to stay in the room. That's not even to do the whole other stuff and all the appointments and all the, like, the epidural and all the, you know, like, dude, 20K. So your kid's already coming out with a debt attached to it if you don't have proper insurance, and
that's
I'm saying. So bullshit. Like, and then you see all this stuff with the kids right now. Like, this is my whole incentive to doing what I'm doing, is I have children, so I have plenty to speak on about it. I was a child once too. And, like, parts of me feel like my whole childhood was even a lie. Not that, like, it made me mad or made me a bad person, but you just realize, like, even watching all these cartoons and shows that I used to watch as a kid with my son now, I'm just like, holy smokes. Like, even in my day, like, that Disney and, like, all these programs, like, they're truly pushing like this agenda on children to, like, believe in this stuff as well. Yeah, subliminally.
Thanks, Satan.
It's subtine, actually.
Got it.
And, like, obviously, you know, like, the live action catches your eye. So see this art and all this stuff that, like, is really into, like, ingrained into society is how they get their religion and their, like, message across, because they're the ones creating it and they're getting inspiration from this dark force. Cause, like I said, the Bible teaches that we're not fighting flesh and blood like humans. We're fighting principalities against in the air, meaning, like, there's spiritual warfare going on right now. If these people are tapped in, that's why you see the one eye, is because it's all about the mind. You know what I mean? Like, the consciousness, they understand that there's more to this life. You know what I mean? Because they're manifesting it and they're, like, putting it on the public. So this is what the public needs to understand, is, like, these people know what they're doing. The government knows what they're doing. Like, this isn't just random. This isn't just humans saying, oh yeah, let's just make all the fast food restaurants yellow, blue, and white and red. Like, let's just do that.
It's more than that, dude. I was just thinking about this today. Like, okay, you go get your food, right? The Food and Drug Administration. We know that the drug, like, Big Pharma basically runs the show right now. Like, take a look at what happened with COVID. Yes. So is it far-fetched to say they poison the food, so you're dependent on the drug, and then that puts you more dependent on the dollar, because now you need to have insurance, maintain a job, you got to go into debt, you know, and the government views its money as a flow of money. So when the government sees a velocity of money, that means their currency is strong. That means people are dependent. If people are able to hold on to their money and save it, that means that their currency, their power is stagnating, because now you have power in your hands. You have something to build against the future. You can survive 4 months. You can change your job. You can move. But if they see a velocity of money, that means, you know, the tentacles are spreading, you know?
Yes.
And the thing you said about the art earlier is, like, if the top level is doing this satanic shit, okay, and the art reflects it, and it gets watered down, and then you get it on your Looney Tunes, like, it's drawing inspiration from what is the original source.
Please enjoy the clip from the Cartoon Network show, Teen Titans.
Illuminati's plan for world domination. All laid out. You were right.
Of course I was!
It was only a matter of time. We could not hide from the master detective forever. I am Lumino, head of the Illuminati!
Hey, the Triangle Man. We came here for answers.
I suppose there's no harm in walking you through our plan for world domination. We did work hard on it. It all starts here, with the banks.
We don't care about the banks.
Tell us about the animals.
Animals?
The pelican, the crab, and the seagull, fool.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Playing dumb, eh? Then we'll have to do this the hard way.
Titans, go!
Conspiracy cover-up! Illuminati laser! Conspiracy grunt! Grassy no game!
Now talk! Where are the animals?
Really? I don't know. I'll stop all our domination plans. I'll pull my lizard men out of Congress. We'll stop using Hollywood to hasten the New World Order. Just let me go.
I like to make these like short little, so people that watch my stuff, even my friends and family, like, this is why I want to get on this type of space, because I can't explain to them in 90 seconds, like, all the stuff that we're talking about. Like, we haven't even got into what we're going to get into today, but there's so much layering that needs to happen and so much deciphering about what's actually going on, that when you just watch it, just like when you go to your stupid little movie and pay 15, 20 bucks for a ticket and think, wow, what a great film. Like, that film was meant to do something to you. Like, it was, you know what I mean? Dude, but you don't walk in there thinking that.
First 5 minutes of a movie, you could write a 100-page book on the psychological operation that has just taken place.
Yes, exactly, dude. So I'm just trying to get people to open up their minds a little bit and like think on a deeper level. Like, that's what it takes to read the Bible too. So many people want to just cherry pick Bible or scripture and say, God's just evil. He likes to do this, that. And it's like, but if you read it in context, like you should watch or read anything, you're seeing that God is actually continuously trying to free humans from this like evil satanic stuff that literally started in the garden with the fall of Eve. And everyone's like, that's a crazy story. How is it a crazy story though, when in 2023, from those thousands of years ago, when that event happened, the same lie is being told by like these celebrities or these kings, queens, whatever, like I said, the hierarchy of society. And you know, at the end of the day, I'm a believer in God, and I believe that these people that are put in power, yes, God allows people to be put in power. And like it says in the Bible, you should, you know, pray for your leaders, which I do. I literally pray for all these people to come out of this stuff, like seriously, because what they're doing, they don't understand either, because they're engulfed in the power and the you know, once you start getting that
milk, assery, you know, they exactly love kissing ass
and it comes from your childhood too. I was raised with a very, you know, Christian foundation. Like, we didn't go to church because my parents, you know, I come from Mormonism, and that's a whole nother topic. But, you know, like I said, my parents lived the life. They didn't just like say we need to go to church and then like didn't, you know, practice what they preach. You know, like, my house was raised on, hey, you respect your parents, my dad, respect your mother, you know, I got sisters, so respect women. So that's like why I care about women even more than the average man, is because I didn't have a brother, I had two sisters and then my mom. So, you know, like, this is all about empowering like everybody, not just like men. And look at men now, they're trying to dominate women in their own gender now. So like,
swimming champion Riley Gaines is threatening legal action against San Francisco State. She says trans activists at the school assaulted her Thursday night after she voiced her opposition to allowing athletes who transition from male to female to compete against women. She tells Tucker Carlson what happens next.
All of a sudden, after my speech, the room was stormed. The lights were turned off, and I was rushed. With no one there to escort me to a safe place, I was punched, I was hit multiple times, I was shoved, until finally we exited the room.
Gaines had to barricade herself inside a classroom for 3 hours, and she says the protesters demanded ransom if she wanted to make it home safely. A university official said she was proud of the students who protested peacefully. Gaines replied that ambush was the opposite of peaceful.
Like, you know, we just need to wake up as a society and see that, like, we are not headed towards good things, or this is not like a Christian nation, because Christ does not call for like what we're supporting. And like I said, I heard somebody say that, like, we can't be hypocrites, and we can't be like, oh, well, if you're an adult, like, you can do whatever you want. You know, look at where, dude, that's also got us. You listen, know what I mean? We need to have some like groundwork of like, look, there's some stuff that's really dangerous to societies, and pedophilia and like this stuff that's going on with the sexualization of children is always at the core of like a lot of downfall to major societies. Like, you study history. See, that's the thing. It's not about conspiracy. Study history and see can a nation, can a country survive this type of blow that when you look at history, it never does. Never.
Yeah. There's a guy named E. Michael Jones, and he wrote a book called Libido Dominati or something. Now, I haven't read it because I'm a millennial and we don't read.
Yeah.
But it basically,
the internet.
Yeah, it translates to sexual liberation is slavery. So when you liberate the family unit, the individual sexually, they become enslaved to their appetite.
And now a page from our Sunday Morning Almanac, June 23rd, 1894, 125 years ago today, the day sex researcher Alfred Charles Kinsey was born in Hoboken, New Jersey. A trained biologist, Kinsey achieved fame, even notoriety, in the 1940s and 50s with a pair of best-selling books about male and female sexual behavior. Controversial research he defended on scientific grounds.
I discovered that there is practically nothing known about human sexual behavior in comparison with what we knew about the sexual behavior of other animals.
Kinsey based his eye-opening findings on thousands of personal interviews, training his researchers to first put their subjects at ease. As portrayed in the 2004 film, Kinsey, starring Liam Neeson.
If you ease in with innocuous questions, people forget they're giving sex histories.
Many of Kinsey's findings and techniques remain controversial, including his occasional reliance on the accounts of admitted child abusers. Still, he's widely hailed as a trailblazer in a previously taboo field. Alfred Kinsey died in 1956 at the age of 62. Today, the research he pioneered continues at the Kinsey Institute at Indiana University in Bloomington.
Known as the father of the sexual revolution, the founder of sexology, and the framer of modern sex ed.
Hello. I'm Dr. Alfred Kinsey.
Alfred Kinsey is the father of sexology.
It's Alfred Kinsey.
The Kinsey Scale.
You can thank one guy for that, Alfred Kinsey.
While he's often portrayed as a self-sacrificing saint scientist, Kinsey was a bad dude who ran a bunch of bad boys. And I mean really bad. Kinsey was complicit in the sexual abuse of children. His own published works included data tables showing children as young as 2 months being, quote, stimulated to, quote, orgasm, while screaming and writhing in pain. He had this data on 200 young boys under the age of 15. But we still revere him and use his data, because being canceled is for statues and working class dudes who said a bad thing on Twitter, not child predators who did bad research. Kinsey may have done bad things, but that doesn't mean we can throw out his good data, because he didn't produce any. Kinsey's research famously found that people in the 1940s weren't following the sexual morals of their time, which isn't surprising, because he oversampled prisoners, homosexuals, prostitutes, and other people living outside the status quo of that era, and then claimed that data represented the entire population. His data also suffered from the fatal flaw of being based on self-reporting. Who in the 40s is going to tell their sexual history to a complete stranger? Freaky people, that's who. You heard it here, but don't take my word for it. Abraham Maslow criticized Kinsey and refused to work with him for this exact reason. It's just bad science. And he got away with some other unethical stuff, too. As PBS described, he hired a photographer to film volunteers and members of his research staff engaging in sexual activity. Porn! He made porn with his staff members. That's what that means. You know, for research. Kinsey purportedly found 26% of married women and 50% of married men cheat. That's 17% to over 50% of farm boys have sex with animals, and that pedophilic abuse isn't necessarily harmful to children. And many of these findings have been uncritically accepted, even though his research included obvious sampling biases and flat-out lies. Why? As humans, we'll basically accept anything as true as long as it tells us we're good people. Whether you're a complete deviant or a relatively upright person, if you believe Kinsey's findings, you're gonna come away thinking, hey, I guess I'm not that bad. How does this affect us today? Well, one of Kinsey's most groundbreaking findings was that chastity is supposedly impossible. Speak for yourself, bud. Sadly, this kind of thinking entirely defines comprehensive sex ed curriculums. And that's no coincidence. Kinsey's disciple Mary Caldrone founded CECUS, and Kinsey's co-author Pomeroy, who openly advocated for incest between adults and children, by the way, was among the founding board members. CECUS pioneered comprehensive sex education and still influences national policy on sex ed standards today. And it's all based on the assumptions of a man who was neither hero nor cartoon villain, a mere mediocre pervert and creep who did what any sick person in such a position would do: spread his disease. Don't let them spread it to your child. Parents across the country are pushing back against so-called comprehensive sex ed. Join the fight. Don't let people you wouldn't leave your kid alone with determine how they should be taught about sex.
You know what I mean? So that, that pushes material rather than family and God. Yes. And it's funny that you say that men are dominating women as women. Because we stopped bullying. We stopped all the shit. We're like, you know, women are as equal to men. And it's like, yeah, so now the weaker men are turning into women they can bully something that, you know, like
they can be strong. I think women are stronger than men because I've children and I watched my wife carry my two children. And let me tell you, that takes more strength than any man ever will, like a push or on a bench or whatever his like mind of strength is. So like all women watching, I think women are stronger than men. This is why I'm so offended at what men are trying to do to women right now and how women are allowing it. And also like that female athlete that got attacked for trying to come out and like just recently, remember?
What was that?
And, God, I forgot her name.
Nah, yeah, man. I don't follow mainstream news. It's
all I don't like following it either, but you have to because this is what the general public is following. And like, so if you want to like be able to relate to people, like you have to use these like sources. So see, I'll use CNN, I'll use MSN, I'll use NBC, I'll use other Fox News. I'll use it all because I'm trying to communicate to everybody that's in this space of like, look, they're all saying their truth because they obviously have to report something and things are happening. Yeah. And
no, you know what I think it is, dude? I think Elon Musk is going to run for president and he's using AI and his power.
Well,
he
technically can't because I think, right, he's not born citizen. But that's funny that you say that because I did some research. I've been doing a lot of research on Elon. This thing called naturalization. This is honestly another topic that we should get into because Elon is crazy. That's for sure. Like people think this guy is awesome and they think that this guy's like,
he's a psychopath, man. I don't know. He's a weirdo. I don't know if it's a business psychopath. You know what I mean?
I mean,
these shit companies that are valued so much money, you know, and then he goes on to the next one and on to the next one. He's and they're all horrible satanic companies.
He's literally using technology that's already been around too. Like this is what I'm saying. People don't understand the government and these like high individuals that are into this engineering stuff. They see things that you have no like idea that you've seen because this is what they're patents. While we're sitting here trying to make a few bucks just to buy some groceries, these people are investigating. These people are flying helicopters. You know, like they got so much money right now.
Yes, they have assets, grants. They can put teams together to
this
test
is what
run
they're
things.
Doing. Yes,
they can fund universities, buy patents, put it all together. Like you don't have $1 million around this week and put an engineering into it and see.
I would love to because I would make some things, that's for sure. Yeah. But yeah, I don't got those type of resources.
And then there's secret knowledge they have amongst each other. And it's like, dude, it's fucking wild, man.
Yeah, so you could get into all that and we could seriously tangent off like a billion things with Elon, but Elon is a player that Christians need to really watch out for because Neuralink, he wants to start putting that in humans. That's not conspiracy. That's just a fact.
He
wants that.
Brain chip AI, satellite AI, Twitter AI. Like the guy is just harvesting as much data as he can.
Yes.
On you.
And to make money and to push product. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So yeah, people need to, like I said, wake up. This is what, remember, the Bible says, Matthew 6, you cannot have two masters in life. You cannot serve God and say you're a follower of Jesus Christ, but then be the richest man in the world. I'm sorry. You can't say that I love money and mammon and I do all these, you know, and I'm not saying that being rich is evil. It's not, money's not the root of all evil. The love of money is the root of all evil. See, when people talk about even that scripture, they're like, money's evil if you have money. Well, there's some really good people with a lot of money because they've been entrusted by the Lord to do good things and that they're going to be good stewards with their money. You know, they've been given that honor to have that money. There are definitely really good people with a lot of money that do good things. But once you start seeing how you have to make a lot of money, you have to be kind of a shady person and you have to start doing deals that, like, you know, I don't know what happens behind closed doors.
No, to be
a
billionaire, man.
Yeah, dude. Yeah,
you gotta have some shady deals, like because
there's
rarely an untapped market. You know, there's always going to reach a point where somebody's going to be in the way. And now, how badly do you want to run over that person?
even in the churches, the 501c3s, you know what I mean? People will be like, what's that? And it's like, well, if you don't know that your church is part of a 501c3 or not, that just shows you how dead the churches are in America, is because
that means they're serving the government, right?
Yeah, that means they're serving the government. They've sold out to the government, and they're saying they're going to use God's name to get government incentives. And some say, oh, well, you have to do it. You don't have to do crap. You just choose to submit. See, that's what Satan's all about, is slowly. See, people think this drastic change is just happening now with like the transgender movement and the sexualization of kids and pedophilia and all that. This has been going on for a long time. This is something that's like I said, times were different. So, you know, sex and the way we looked at children, you know, 14, you were a grown adult. Like I said, that's not what we're getting into. We're getting into today's standards are that teens are teens and they are kids and they have undeveloped minds and should not be pushed with this type of things or like sexualized, and they shouldn't have this like overbearing feeling about like they don't know who they are. That's what growing up is part of doing, is like figuring out who you are, what you want to be. Like, you can't just decide these things at 7, 8 years old. Like, you don't even know what money means. You know what I mean? You don't understand nothing. You just wake up and you have food on in front of your face. You know what I mean? So it's really sad how like we've almost made kids be like kids for too long too. Yeah, so I'm all about protecting kids, and people can hate me all they want about whatever I say or believe. But at the end of the day, Jesus literally says, like, anybody that harms kids, like, you better get ready for some serious judgment, because that's innocence that we're now, you know, messing with. Like, me and you, we're adults. We've made our decisions. We have sins. You know, we know the things that we do and choose. And while not always the best choices, we understand the consequence of them. These kids don't understand that. These kids are helpless. Yep. They're literally, they learn everything from you. Or the TV, whatever it is, whatever it is that's raising your kid, that's where they will learn it from. So if you're sending your kid off to daycare and school, hey, I'm not judging people, because I understand you got to have jobs. But now the daycare is raising your school. My, see, that's the kind of old school family I come from. One parent was always home with the kid, because my parents just didn't love other people.
If you raise us, like, what is the ratio of the time your kid is spending with you versus everything else? I mean, it should be like 70 to 30 your way. You know what I mean?
You're exactly like, right about that. Like I said,
like a screen, TV, movie, that doesn't count as raising time. That counts as the TV is raising your kid now.
And I've been, you know, because there's sometimes like my, you know, like I said, my wife works, I'm a stay at home dad. So that's just how my house works. And so you got to get some stuff done. You can't just sit around and play with your kid and do the toys all day and stuff, you know? So you do have to put them in front of the screen. You don't have to, but you know what I mean? It makes it really hard to just make them lunch, even for a hot second. You don't have something that can just distract them for a second. So, but I play like Christian stuff. So you can choose the type of content too. Some people just put YouTube Kids on and let their kid just that is so dangerous. If you're listening to me right now, do not let your kids watch YouTube Kids. Like, seriously, take that with seriousness right now. Like, I'm putting a serious public service announcement. Do not let your kids freely watch YouTube Kids.
Have you seen some crazy shit on that?
Bro, we could go right now to something and I would make everybody truly disgusted. And it's on there, so I don't know why we shouldn't, because this is the kind of stuff that's being advertised to children right now. It's called Cuckoo Kangaroo.
Thanks for tuning in. To know the duty of a watchman, please read Ezekiel 33. Join the movement today. Follow on Instagram at Watchman Inc. for more details, content, and community interaction. Links in the description. God bless.